Yes. Thank you very much for tuning into the road safety unit. We know you have many choices where you could be listening to other information, but we are happy you chose to listen to road safety and to get some road safety empowerment, especially during this weekend. Too many persons have been killed in road traffic crashes since the start of this year. And just to look at the weekend collisions, we are seeing whereby so far this year, quite a bit of persons have been killed. To be exact, 116 persons have been killed on the weekends. Right? So we have 249 people dead. And then at the same time that we have that number, we have 116 being killed on the weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. No, this is not nice. Over the period 2017 to present, we have lost 707 persons. Too many precious lives have been lost, and we need to do better as a people. My name is Ken Youth here, Director of the Road Safety Unit. And I will be presenting to you on a very important topic that hopefully you will take it serious and make the requisite adjustments to keep yourself safe. Well, road safety affairs is predicated on five fundamental pillars in accordance with the United Nations Decade of Action for Road Safety. And we are trying our best to see how we can ensure that our road safety alignments are in accordance with best practices as best as possible. So we need to work together with everyone, including the population, to stem the tide of traffic crashes that continues to negatively affect the socioeconomic fabric of our society. Road safety is predicated on three fundamental legs: human being, environment, and the mechanical. And therefore, we have to ensure that there is equilibrium and there are no imbalances. Right? So please, we beg of you to play your part in stemming the tide of traffic crashes. We have to start with music. When it hits you, you feel no pain.
Drinking, no driving. crashes are very disastrous events. They add nothing positive to the lives of anyone. All traffic crashes do. They bring disaster. They bring destruction. They are filled with negativity. And we need to abhor it. We need to do the right thing. Right? We are going to speak about issues that is going to affect us and that has been affecting us for a while. And therefore, we need to take heed. Between 2017 to present, right? Since 2017 to present, we have lost 707 persons during crashes that transpire on the weekends. If you look at the graph, look at the table here, you see in 2017 we lost 157 persons, 2018 we lost 202 persons, and last year we lost 2019, we lost 232 persons on the weekend. You'd recall that last year we lost 440 persons in traffic crashes, right? And so last year alone, we had more than 50% of the persons dying on the weekends, right? This is cause for concern. I think the next present we're going to do, we're going to show you the cause of the crashes that took place on the weekend. So far this year, 116 persons have been killed on the weekends. So again, this is an issue that, that as a population, we need to take very serious, and we need to try to do our utmost best to keep ourselves safe, keep ourselves alive for our families. The most killed road user on the weekend is a motorcyclist. 201 motorcyclists have died on the weekend, right? 201 motorcyclists have died on the weekend. This is cause of profound concern because coupled followed by them, hurriedly, pedestrians, 161 have died on the weekend. 120 private motor vehicle drivers have been killed, and 99 private motor vehicle passengers have been killed. Now I can tell you that most of these drivers and passengers killed during on the weekend, they were never wearing seatbelts. And remember, I told you earlier that if you don't wear your seatbelt, you are not giving yourself a fighting chance to survive. I'm going to beseech people again, please wear your seatbelts. Do not compromise with your life. Do not compromise with your safety. You only have one life. And do not die before your time in a traffic crash. Right? Traffic crashes have robbed Jamaica of many persons. So in 2017, this is a graphical representation of it. Most of the persons who died on the weekend died in Westmoreland, St. Catherine, St. Andrew, right? These are the dominant parishes where a person died in 2017. So look at where you have the red, right? And from here to the red, you know it dread, right? So please, people, take your safety serious. Now in 2018, there was a shift. The parishes of St. Catherine and St. Andrew dominated where persons die, right? So we ought to be taking these things very serious, right? These persons died in 2018. To 2019, there's a shift taking place again. So it is shifting around. The dominant parishes were St. Anne and St. Catherine, right? So it moved from the southern coast, gone up to both the southern and the northern coast. But in 2020, so far, Westmoreland is the parish that has dominated as it relates to deaths on the weekend. So people, please be careful on the weekend. Now, when we look at the data in its entirety between 2017 to present, what we are seeing is the parish of St. Catherine dominating. So if you notice, there is a trend that has been happening from as far back as 2017, where the parish of St. Catherine continued to dominate throughout, right? No let up at all. So I would like to encourage persons in St. Catherine to do better. St. Catherine is a big parish, so we need everybody to join forces on the road safety train. All right, so please, please, beg of you. Right. However, the parish of St. Andrew and Westmoreland are on the heels of St. Catherine. So as it relates to weekend crashes, St. Catherine is the dominant parish, followed by St. Andrew and Westmoreland. Right? Please do that. Now, this is a season when we're having a lot of rain. This is hurricane season, right? So therefore, I really want people to pay attention to what I'm going to say now. Right? When driving, the speed limit sign that you see on the road surface, the road in the traffic environment, are not for wet roads. Let me go again. Any speed limit sign that you see on the network, they are not for wet roads. Speed limit signs are for dry roads. I hope everybody understands that. Because I don't believe that persons are understanding that there is a dynamics with operating on a wet road. On a dry road, and I have a problem with that because I've been doing some questioning of persons who have driver's license, and their instructor never told them anything about wet road. Some of them never drive on a wet road when they were learning to drive. Some of them were taught by parents and friends how to drive, but they were never taught about wet roads. And that is why I always tell her that I don't have any confidence in parents, friends, teaching anyone to drive. The level of driving instruction in this country is cause for concern. The level of driving instruction that people are getting is cause for concern. Right? And I would like to tell people, visit the Road Safety YouTube channel, visit the Ministry of Transport Facebook channel, and if when you watch all today's going to be the 14th video, when you watch all 14 videos, and if when you watch every 14 video, you can come and say, Road Safety, my instructor taught me everything you spoke about. We have a prize for you and the instructor. Yes, man, we have a prize for you and the instructor. Right? We have a prize for you and the instructor. Right? People, those of you who log into our channel and get information, I am certain that your eyes are going to be open much more than it has been open before. We are delivering road safety frenesis, road safety sonesis, road safety tushia, and road safety sophia. We are delivering it. Because we find no solace reporting that 249 of our people are dead because of road traffic crashes. So we are going to speak about a topic, and for you, many of you out there, who, when you were learning to drive, your instructor never tell anything about wet roads. Just pay attention to this for me now, please. Roads tend to be slippery when wet. Why? Because when motor vehicles drive on the road surfaces, they tend to drip oil. And when the rain falls,
the water caused the oil to come to the surface, and then you will see all different types of coloration on the road surface. That first downpour of water is very dangerous. You need to be extremely careful. Remember that the only part of the motor vehicle that touches the road is the tire. So therefore, you should make it your point of duty to ensure you have on good tires. Tires are like shoes on the human body. The same way you ensure you have on proper shoes, ensure you have on proper tires on your motor vehicle. Too many times, persons have bald tires out there and they get themselves into trouble. Gentle people, if you want to know about tires, check out our tire safety intelligence YouTube video. Yes, man. We have a tire safety intelligence YouTube video on the Road Safety Unit YouTube channel. Yes, man. We have it here. Go at it, read it, watch it, eat it, drink it. And after you have done that, go and look at your tire. I'm challenging you. Put in the chat room if when you were learning to drive, your instructor taught you all of those things that we have in our tire safety video. Yes, man, put in the chat room, right? People, we have to do better. Too many of our people are dead. Too many of our people die on the weekend. 116 out of the 249 dead people died on the weekend. We can't count it like this. Next week, we're going to tell you the factors that contribute to those dead. But these are things we want to do, to consider for this weekend. Consider your ways. Yes, man. Consider your ways. When the road surface is wet, people, whether it is rain or whether it is pipe burst and water on the surface, friction is reduced. So friction on the road is reduced. Now, the drag factor now is reduced because, you know, placing an object on the road surface, so apart from the coefficient of friction for that road surface is reduced because of water, the drag factor, which is the relationship between the tire and the road surface, is reduced also. So what this means? This means once these things are reduced, you therefore going to find out you need more time to stop the vehicle. This should be traction instead of fraction. Traction is reduced. Remember that you need traction to deal with wet surfaces. And that is why tires are built with traction. And if you have watched our tire safety presentation, you would see where we need traction for wet surfaces to be able to stop and maneuver on wet surfaces. And I told you that when you are buying tires, buy tires with traction A or double A. Do not buy traction B, nor traction C, nor traction D, etc. Buy traction A. Your driving instructor should have taught you these things when they were training you to drive. They must know these things. Oh, you can't be training people to drive and you don't teach people about tires. Big jokes, man. Big jokes. Gentle people, visit the Road Safety Channel. Visit it. So when the road is slippery, the possibility of skidding is increased. Braking distance is also increased. Steering control is decreased. Therefore, the risk of an accident is increased. Gentle people, be not deceived out there when you see wet road that you're going to speed up on it. Don't do it. Do not do it. If you do it, you could end up into boneyard. Boneyard, not nice.
We die before our time. We die before our time. Gentle people, this is not a joke business. Hydroplaning or aquaplaning, right? This is a condition in which the tires glide or float on a film of water. The tires are no longer on the road surface. The tires are doing the Jesus thing, walking on water top. But the tires is not Jesus. And your motor car is not Jesus. So please, understand this, right? That the water of a depth of 2 millimeters or more can trigger this condition. There is absolutely no maneuver that can correct hydroplaning. Do not brake, do not steer, and do not gas up either. Once you see bodies of water on the road surface, cut the speed. Prevention is better than cure. Right? Prevention is better than cure. Now, when you see wet roads, you see, and when you see body of water on the road, and you, for whatever reason, you find that you are hydroplaning, because you'll feel it in the steering where the tires are gliding on the road. So you'll feel like the tire skating, the vehicle skating. Remove your foot from off the gas, brake pedal, and you hold that steering tight, straight. Do not speed up. Do not brake. Do not steer. Your driving instructor should have told you these things, because a crash took place. A crash took place in St. James since weekend. And when we look at that crash, we see, apart from indiscipline, because none of the occupants were wearing protective devices. Right? But you know what hurt me more than anything else? It's to know that a two-year-old died in that crash. The two-year-old was not in a child seat. It is blatantly clear that the parent of this two-year-old was speeding. Water on the road surface. Speeding through water and braking. No, man, you can't do that. You cannot do that. So, you know what I would love? I would love, you see, every driver watch these videos we have up, that we have been doing since July 1st. I would love for every driver across Jamaica, every nook and cranny of Jamaica, to watch these things. Now, they are there. We already know that there are many things that you can make up your mind that you want to watch, but we would encourage you to watch these things, because as far as I'm concerned, the information that we are providing are very useful information, and the information is for empowerment. So when rain is falling, drive slowly, right? Drive slowly on wet roads. Do not take anything for granted, right? Cut your speed. Remember, I tell you already, there are no speed limits in Jamaica for wet roads. There, no speed limit. Just let me tell you that. And if you think you can drive 110 kilometers per hour through a body of water and get away with it, you make a sad mistake. When that vehicle hydroplane, listen to me, the vehicle take off like a baby kite, right? And then you find yourself into serious problems, right? Serious problems. People, you cannot be driving a vehicle and don't know how to operate when the road is wet.
You need to ensure that you are aware of these things and not only become aware, but also do the right thing out there. 249 people dead already. These oil spills on the road, these when the road is wet and the oil lubricants from the vehicle that drop it come up on the road surface, this can cause skidding. So you need to take your time on the road. Take your time. I see people speeding, rain is falling, and people speeding. And then when they crash, they wonder, they say they're salt. You're not salt, man. You're not salt. The friction between the tire and the road surface decreases. Right? So please, people, please. Tire grip decreases and braking distances increases. Right? Vehicles can easily spin out of control, skid off the road, slide uncontrollable, and cause havoc. So therefore, when next time it rains, slow down. Slow down and live. Live. Life is sweet. So hydroplaning can result from poor or worn tires. Remember, I tell that the tread depth in the tire is to disperse water. So you have bald tires, you're not supposed to be speeding on the road. Driving too fast and on a wet surface, no matter the condition of the tires. Once you see water on the road, cut the speed. It is big jokes to be speeding on wet road. Big jokes. Please to ensure that you have tread depth that is not less than 1.66 millimeters. Ensure that your tires are inflated to the correct pressure, allowing for proper contact with the road surfaces. Drive moderately slowly across streams of water, and especially during rainfall, cut your speed, people, cut it. Just like how we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, right? Before we go further, let us pray. I forget to pray. Father God, just bless this presentation, Almighty God. Cover this presentation with the blood of Jesus Christ and Nazareth. Cover it from hackers, Almighty God. Block them in the name of Jesus Christ and Nazareth. Father, we plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon this presentation. And Father God, those who are planning to hack us and those who have hacked us in the past, Almighty God, Father God, blunt their attacks against our sight in the name of Jesus Christ and Nazareth. Cover this presentation with the blood. Cover it in the name of Jesus. Protect us, guard us, shield us, so that we deliver many more presentations in the name of Jesus. And Father God, may this presentation and all the other presentations go out to every nook and cranny across this country. May every driver, may every motorcyclist, may every passenger, may every pillion, may every pedestrian, and may every learner driver and every potential driver come to the Road Safety Unit channel and get Frenes, Road Safety Frenes, Sonesis and Sophia and Tushia in the mighty name of Jesus. By fire and by force, Almighty God, we decree, we declare, by the finger of God, Almighty God, this road safety message, this road safety gospel, go out, Almighty God. And may as it go out, Almighty God, the people of Jamaica, the drivers, all road users become road safety game changers. And Father God, through our actions and their actions, may we see a reduction in road deaths. Father, every crash victim and their family members, Almighty God, cover them now, Almighty God. Bless them, Almighty God. And Father God, those who have lost loved ones as a result of traffic crashes, Almighty God, Father, bring peace, Almighty God, to them. Father God, help them during this process. Guard them, shield them, carry them through. And may Almighty God, they join the road safety train and become road safety warriors. They become road safety game changers and they become road safety zealots in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, answer this prayer, Almighty God. But Father, give us the strength to do our works, Almighty God, because faith without works is dead, Almighty God. Father God, as we put in the work, Almighty God, bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless everyone listening to us in the name of Jesus. We give you all the praise, all the honor, all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Yes, you know, it's customary for us to pray before we get into the presentation. But this time, it slipped me to start the presentation with prayer. But we're going to give God. We always give God thanks for life. We give thanks for everything. And we want God to bless this presentation. And we want it to go out to everybody. And once they watch it, once they listen to it, they will become road safety game changers. Now, as I was saying, in a traffic crash, just like how we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, yes? And just like how we have a body, a soul, and a spirit, there are three things involved in a crash. Three things. I want everybody to learn this, right? Because it's these three things that have played a role in the deaths of 707 persons on weekend during the period 2017 to right now. So the first collision is that the vehicle collided with something. Vehicle collision. Second collision, human body collides with the vehicle interior. Third collision, internal organs collide with the human body. So let's just have a look at that. Yeah, man. Everybody, take a listen. Everybody watch. Get wisdom, people. Get wisdom.
Richard didn't want to die, but he couldn't stop himself. The collision with the car didn't kill him, but he wasn't wearing a seatbelt, so he continued on his journey. When he hit the inside of the car, that didn't kill him either. But his internal organs carried on traveling until they hit his ribcage, and his lungs were punctured, and the main artery from his heart was torn. And that's what killed Richard.
It is very, very serious. It is sad. We lost. I must say that. You see that 2-year-old that died in St. James. Out of that vehicle, that 2-year-old brought the number to 250. It's sad, very sad. When you look at that crash, you realize that everybody in that crash died before their time. It was a poor choice that was executed. Poor choice, right? Indiscipline. And I really hope and pray that the family members will be strengthened. We're going to keep them in our prayers, right? And all the other crash victims in Jamaica. People, let me tell you something. You see, as somebody who should have died in 1980 because of a traffic crash, right? I should have died in a crash in 1980. Yep, I should have died. I know that these things are not good things. They are not good things. And therefore, that is why we come here twice a week since July to feed you with road safety information. Because due to the COVID-19 protocols, we can't operate like how we usually operate. So that is the reason why we are putting everything out here. Now, we have made a decision, you see, it's very calculated, that we are going to give the road safety information to every Jamaican. So once you have access to the internet, continue to check out the Road Safety Unit YouTube channel, right? Because we are going to upload everything there. We are going to put everything there so that you can be better empowered. And we are yet to see anyone coming for the prize, whereby once you watch all 14 videos, as of today, going to be number 14. Once you watch the 14 videos, and you can tell us that everything that we speak about from July 1st till August the 14th, your instructor taught you these things. Yes. Once your instructor taught you these things, we want you to bring the instructor and yourself. Come on, Road Safety, we'll give you a prize. Yes, man, we give you a prize. We want to give you a prize. right? Nobody take up that yet. We are in serious issue. We are. It's not 249 dead. It's 250 now. It gone to 250 now. 250 gone now. I hope that by the time I finish this presentation, it don't gone 251. I hope so. We're not even finished August, and we're gone 250. People, that's big jokes. Big jokes, people. People, we have to do better. We must do better. Now, so the vehicle collision is where the vehicle collide with some object, whether it's a tree, a wall, etc. Right? Now, after the vehicle collision, you see, after your vehicle collision, remember I tell you, you know, it's three things involved. Right? Three things involved. Let me go back. Right. So it's a vehicle, you have nose vehicle, and you have vehicle without nose. This vehicle here that you see right here, it have a nose right here. Right here it have the nose. So you find that cars have nose. So cars that you see with a bonnet, that's the nose. So any vehicle with a bonnet, that means it have a nose. Now if the vehicle don't have a bonnet, it don't have a nose. It therefore means that if you are driving these vehicles without nose like this, yeah, like these vehicles don't have nose. Once you drive any of these vehicles, please to be very careful out there. Look out for bad drivers. Look out for drivers who may want to run in your vehicle. And you must also not run into people's vehicles, and you must not crash either. Because if you're involved in a crash, you know, these vehicles without nose, if you're involved in a crash with them, the lower limbs going to get hit. So expect foot injuries from anybody who is at the front. Just want you to be aware of that. Be more careful on the road, man. Be more careful. Human collision involves the movement of occupants in the vehicle are still moving at the same speed that the vehicle is traveling. Whatever speed the motor vehicle is going, that's the speed at which the human body is going. That's the speed at which your eyes, your ears, your nose, your foot, your liver, your kidney, your spleen, your myelin sheath, your pancreas is traveling at. Hello, gentle people. Watch this.
The time just heal all the pain you feel. Let the rain that's falling down wash it all away. My one regret, I'll see it
without a seatbelt. You're not just hurting yourself.
Gentle people, wear your seatbelt. Wear your seatbelt, people. Wear your seatbelt. We beg of you, wear it. Buckle up. Ensure that all your passengers are buckled up. Do not take it for granted at all. Don't take it for granted. You see, we enter this world, you know, and the Most High said in Psalms chapter 90 that we can live to see 70. He also said that we can get 80, so we can live to see 80 years old. Yes, man, we can live to see it. But we have to make some choices if we want to live to see those age. And we have to do the right thing on the road network. We have to do the right thing. We cannot do the wrong thing, you know. Right? In the books, it tell you, you know, whatever seed you sow, that is what you're going to reap. So let us sow good seeds on the road network. We have been sowing bad seeds on the road network. We refuse to wear seed there. Refuse to wear helmet. Refuse to carry children in car seat. We refuse to hear that when rain is falling and when road full up of water, we must stop speed. We disobedient, man. And that is why we have 250 people dead. Hello. We need to cut out the foolishness, man. Seven hundred and seven people dead on weekends. between 2017 till now. 116 people dead already. And weekends since the start of this year, 116. We have lost 116. Greatness. These people have greatness to fulfill. So we know who are alive now need to take heed and take debt and my debt, because we have needlessly lost our people. Hello. So we appeal to drivers, occupants, right, to understand themselves. Do the right thing. If you see slackness going on around you, don't support it, man. Oppose it. Reject it, man. I see some taxi man, you know. I see some taxi man, right? Yes, man. I see some taxi man. Right at the intersection of Devon House, the intersection of King's House Road and Hope Road. They go out in the far right lane. They're supposed to turn right to go up King's House Road. They come there, and all of a sudden you just see one of them come right in front of you. Then you see another one come going, where you learn to slack this, man? Hello? Where you learn that from? I would like to call upon the JCFC to visit those areas. Visit those intersections from where them is now. Right. Devon House intersection. Devon House is one. Devon House intersection. King's House intersection. And Ligani intersection. And the Papin intersection. Yes, man. That's where they're doing it. That's where they're doing it. And write every ticket that is in the book. And if their driver's license is suspended, suspend. We need to cut out the slackness, man. And passengers in the motor vehicle. You passengers in the motor vehicle. Stop take them. Let me tell you about these drivers. A lot of these drivers, you see, they don't respect the passenger's life. They only see the passengers as $100 bill. Look at your passenger. Your value more $100. Passengers, stop put up with the slackness with these drivers. Stop doing it. I have seen passengers put up with the slackness of these drivers, and they end up seriously injured. They all end up dead too. We need to do better out there. The type of driving out there is pathetic. We see people overtaking without due care. We see people want to make a right turn and put an indicator. Right? And we see other people way down the road speeding up. Where you get those behavior from? Where you get it from? Where you learn these things from? Cut out the selfishness on the road, man. Cut it out. The human collision is real, people. It is real. The human body collide with the interior of the vehicle, which include objects in the vehicle, include people in the vehicle. Buckle up. The collision only slows or stops the human body. The collision that determines whether you live or dead is the internal organ collision. This occurs when the occupant's internal organ moves towards the point of impact and may hit other bones, organs, or skull. The body may appear uninjured, however, internal organ may be torn, bruised, or bleeding. Go to your doctor. Once involved in a traffic crash, go to your doctor. 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 The internal organ of the body is traveling at the same initial speed as the occupant. It strikes something inside the body. So you're traveling at 90 kilometers per hour. That, and your crash, that internal organ is going to strike the inside of the body at 90 kilometers per hour. Every organ inside the body will be striking each other at 90 kilometers per hour. Who you think will win? Did your instructor teach you these things? Put it in the chat room. Again, the collision slows or stops the internal organs. Oftentimes, we see the fire brigade coming to the scene of the crashes, and we must big up the fire brigade for their profound assistance. And may God continue to bless our fire brigade as they strive to save lives. They will extract crash victims from the motor vehicle. They will also remove debris and body parts from the crash scene. Right? And people, let us make better choices out there. What personality are you? What personality are you as a driver? Are you a driver with bad attitude? Are you a driver who is knowledgeable? Are you a driver with good attitude? Are you a driver without knowledge? Are you a driver who recognizes that we operate in a dynamic traffic environment, so we need to be alert at all times? Are you that driver? Or are you not that driver? Are you a driver who has emotional control? Are you that driver? Are you a driver who is rude and opportunistic? Are you a driver who is prudent and fair? Are you a driver who is foul-mouthed? Are you that driver who is foul-mouthed? If you are foul-mouthed, stop it. Whenever I'm driving on the road network and anybody curse me, I cancel that curse in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I cancel it in the name of Jesus. So I encourage every man, woman, and child who listen to me now, if you are driving on the road network and you are cursed, cancel that curse in the name of Jesus, because word, sound, power here. Word, sound, power. Where I come from, I will start word, sound, power. I will start, do not allow anyone to speak negatively about you. And if they speak negatively about you, you cancel that in the name of Jesus Christ and Nazareth. Or you place it in the blood of Jesus Christ and Nazareth. So because you have some people out there who will curse you. Life and death lies in the power of the tongue. Have control over your emotions. Just remember, you see, that you may know the right thing, but they don't know. And that is why we are moving with such speed to get the road safety message out there. Right? And we hope that as we put it out there, people will eat it up. Because we are fully aware that many instructors did not teach you these things. Driving is not about pressing gas and brake and steering. That's not what driving is. Driving is ensuring that you have good personality. And if what we are speaking about, you have any bad things in your mind, your body, your soul, and your spirit, we edit it out with information. Have proper judgment. Make proper judgment. Be calm in the traffic environment. Be calm. Be relaxed. Don't stress about yourself. There are worlds to be conquered. Develop a positive mental attitude. There's a book that I love by Dr. Norman Vincent Peale, The Power of Positive Thinking. Go and read that book. Avoid negative. Avoid every form of negativity out of your subconscious. Get it out. Think positive. My father tell me that I must not use the word can't. Try. Try and do the right thing out there, man. Try and do. So even if, listen to me, even if you are the only person out there doing the right thing, you'll be the only one. You'll be the beacon. And if people laugh at you because you do the right thing, don't put them in the mind. Don't put them in the mind. Don't put them in the mind. Don't listen to them. You do the right thing because you're saving lives and you're saving your life. 250 dead already, yeah? They don't come tell me about no more additional. What is your responsibility, social responsibility? Are you helpful? Are you forgiving? We always say the Lord's Prayer, you see? The Lord, part of the Lord's Prayer that I find very interesting. It said that we must forgive. And after we forgive, God will forgive us. Yes, so we must forgive. Forgive people who are doing bad things on the network. Do not try to be judge, juror, and executioner out there. Ask yourself a question. Was this person trained? Was this person provided with the level of information I have? And I'm going to tell you this. I'm sorry. But they were not. Because what we are bucking up out there make us affected to this forum. Right? And provide the information in a sustainable way. Previously, we went to different places. We deliver a presentation here and there. But now we're changing. We're still doing that, but we're adding some little nuggets to it. Yes, we're adding some little nuggets. Get wisdom, people. Your mental health is proper. Right? So take care of it. Avoid negative fantasies and delusional mental pattern. Be kind on the network. Remember this, people. Remember this. I am telling you this. This is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing persons who were never taught many things that they should have been taught. Right? And that is why we're trying to get it out. And that's why you know who know better must also join the Road City train and preach the Road City gospel. Yes, we want you to preach the Road City gospel too. Now, one of the most killed road users is the motorcyclist. 79 motorcyclists are dead right now. And based on projection, we're going to go over 100. But what I would like, you see, is that you help us. The Ministry of Health said that because of the prevalence of sexually transmitted disease, they came up with this advertisement. This one right here. Everybody can see it. Everybody know it. The Ministry of Health said, motorcyclist and man, it's a man, cover your second head. The Ministry of Health said, man, cover your second head. That's what the Ministry of Health said. Yes, that's what they said. So why do you think they come up with pinch, leave an inch, and roll? Why do you think they do it? It's to protect the second head. But road safety now said, protect the first head with a helmet. Yeah, man, protect the first head. This one is the first head. Yeah, man, protect the helmet. Yeah, man, protect it. Protect it. Put it in the chat room if you protect your first head. Yeah, man. Put it in the chat room if you protect your first head. Put it in the chat room if you protect your first head. Remember, I tell you, you don't come here with spare parts. So there are no spare heads available to us. Yeah? None whatsoever. You try to take care of your heads, them. Yeah, man? Take care of the heads, them. The Ministry of Health said, protect the second head. Pinch, leave an inch and roll. Now, here are road citizens now. Road citizens say, protect the first head. Because if you don't protect the first head, there will be nothing to pinch, leave an inch and roll. Yes. It's serious. So, tell your motorcycle friend them that. Tell them that. We're going to Peter's Field on Sunday, see? And we're going to tell them again. We tell them last week. Last week, we never have this photograph to show them. And we have the video too. We have the video. Yeah, man. We have the video. It's because we have some technical difficulties. So we can't play the video. Right? Right? But guess what? We're going to play the video. Soon we're going to play it. Right? We're going to play that pinch, leave an inch and roll video. You need to know. Motorcyclists, cover your first head so that you can pinch, leave an inch and roll. Because if you don't protect the first head, there will be nothing to pinch, leave an inch and roll. Just remember that. Just remember, sir, road safety, they tell you. Yeah, man. Always wear helmet, motorcyclist. If you are wearing open face helmet, wear goggles. Do not have passengers sitting on the bike like this. Motorcycles have an helmet, passenger don't have an helmet. This is recklessness, right? Remember that motorcycles have spare parts, but we as human beings don't have spare parts. Remember, I showed you a while ago, out of the 207 people who dead on weekends, 201. Out of the 707 persons who have died on the weekend, 201 were motorcyclists. So we have to talk about motorcyclists again. Because we want you to think, these are those things we want you to consider this weekend, you know. Yes, man. We want you to consider these things this weekend. Right? So road safety, we're going to try and ensure that every weekend, we have some things we want you to consider as you're going weekend. Because see, in the book of Haggai, chapter 1, it says, must consider your ways, you know. If you don't consider your ways, and you're going to put your money in a bag with pure holes. I just say, read Haggai chapter 1 and you will see it. I have never seen a motorcycle being operated on a hospital bed. Never, never, never. If anybody ever see a doctor operating on a motorcycle in a hospital bed, send me that picture. You get a prize. Yeah, man, you get a prize. Wear a full face helmet. Ensure, this is my preference. I don't like half face. I don't like that. I don't like nothing half. I like everything full. So wear a full face helmet. This ensure that your entire face is fully covered. And again, we enter this world without spare parts. The 1999 protective devices legislation in Jamaica requires all pillion and motorcycles to wear a helmet every time, not sometime. The standards for motorcycle helmets are the DOT helmet, UNECE helmet, British standard helmet, which is the BS, and the GIS standard with the Japanese standard. Please, people, make sure your helmet falls within one of these standards. Okay. Now, those who don't like to wear safety gears, let me assure you what type of injuries you will get if you are involved in a traffic crash. You're going to get serious brain injuries. You're going to get shoulder injuries. You're going to get heavy bruising. You're going to get laceration. You're going to get back injuries. You're going to get hand and finger damage. You're going to get busted kneecap. You're going to get road rash. You're going to get severe skin loss. You can get toe amputation and your skin will be chippy chippy. And they will call you chippy chippy. When I was growing up, there was a boy in the community. He never wear none of these things. He crashed, and as him crash, he get chippy chippy. And right away, he get a name chippy chippy. Up to this day, he name chippy chippy. Right? So take heed. Now, if you don't want to be chippy chippy, and you don't want any of these injuries, you will use wisdom. Wisdom say, wear protective gears, wear helmet. Cover the first head, people. Cover the first head. Remember, I tell you, you know, the first head is very important. Very important. Because the first head is it that controls the entire body. Right? And without the head, it's dead. All right. Now, helmet. Make sure it have eye protection also. When you wear safety gears, you're protecting the head. You're protecting the brain. You're protecting the eye. When you wear these shoulder pad and these these knee pad, elbow pad, and shoes, you are protecting these vital organs in the on the body. Wear gloves, right, to protect the knuckles. So if you look at this, fool's gear, right? Fool's gear, yeah? So this is the gears of the fools. Yeah, man. The gears, cool gears, wisdom gears. Now, when I was growing up, you see, my grandmother say, tell us, the fool learned from his own mistake, and the wise man learned from a fool's mistake. No, I want everybody to be wise. Wear helmet, wear face shield, wear gloves, wear jacket and pants, wear boots. Do not wear flip-flops. Do not go out there with bare limbs. Do not wear shorts. Make sure you have on your hands with gloves and cover your eyes, your ears, and your face, and your head. I'll tell you motorcycles, you see. You have the temerity to tell me that the reason why you're not wearing helmet is because the girl's not going to see you. Well, hear this. Girl's not going to want a chippy-chippy. Straight up. Right? You try to cover your head, right? Cover your head, wear your jackets, wear your safety clothing so that we don't have no more than 79 dead. It must stop right here, 79 dead. Already, we don't want no more. We don't want no more, man. Tired of it. So you look at this picture. So look how it chippy-chippy. Look how I'm chippy-chippy. Yes, man. But look here. Look how I'm staying. I'm having clothing, protective clothing. Wear it. Guess it, man. Wear it. All right. One in every two motorcyclists going to die between St. James and St. Elizabeth. Yeah, man. So for every two motorcycle fatalities you're going to hear about, one is going to come from between St. James and St. Elizabeth. Yes. That's the motorcycle area of Jamaica. 53% of the motorcyclists killed died in Western Jamaica. Take that time out, that. 79 motorcyclists are dead so far, 84 died last year this time. Right? When we wear protective clothing, we have the possibility, protective clothing and gears, we can reduce head injuries by up to 69%. We can reduce fatalities by up to 42%. We can reduce the risk of injury to hand by up to 45%. We can reduce the risk, the wound injury, open wound injury by up to 73%. Just by wearing the jacket and these things, we can reduce the risk of injuries by up to 23%, right? And we can reduce the risk of injury of an open wound by 63% just by wearing the safety gear, the jacket and those things. We can do that. Just by wearing shoes, we can wear, instead of slippers, we can reduce the risk of wound injury by up to 90%, right? Just by doing these things, right? We can do these things. By just wearing shoes, proper shoes, we can reduce the risk of injury to our feet by up to 45%. Just by wearing a kneecap, wearing the elbow pad, the knee pad, we can reduce knee injuries by up to 50%. Just by wearing the elbow pad, we can reduce elbow injuries by up to 50%. So just by wearing these safety gear, we can save a lot of lives. If we're really serious, people, listen to me. You see, if we're serious, we can do it. Yes, man, we can do it. But what I notice in this country, you see, we don't take road safety serious. We don't take it serious. A lot of us, when we hear about the deaths, we say, oh, we jump up and we make noise. And then we go back and do the foolishness. And then we say, the persons who died, they never know how to do the thing. We say it can't happen to us because we know how to hold our liquor. We know how to drive. We know how to do recklessness. But gentle people, let me warn you. Do the right thing. Yes, that's all I have to say. Do the right thing. No, motorcyclists, stop, remove the rearview mirrors off the bike. It's reckless. Right? And if you are part of this no headlight crew, yes? Come out of that crew. Yeah, man, come out of that crew. Come out of it. That's not a good crew. That's a negative crew. Yes, man. That's why we have head-on collisions. So tell me something now. After you remove the rear view mirror off the bike, you see? After you remove them, like how you remove them here, so yeah, man. So tell me something. So if a vehicle is out of control behind you, you have eyes behind you? Put in a chat room if you have eyes behind you. Yeah, man, put in chat room. It's a poor style. Put them back on. The only place that I ever see with eyes right around is in the book of Ezekiel chapter 1. Yes, man. Right? Come on, people. Come on, people. Come on, people. Come on, people. Right? We are happy that we have a good possibility to save some lives. And we're going to save lives, you know. We're going to save lives. We're going to do it. So these, because all of us, fam, we listen to this message. I know that a lot of you, just by listening to this message, you're going to be road safety warriors and road safety game changers. If you listen to this message and be, and remain the same, no, man, you have to do better, man. You have to do better. The rearview mirror enables a driver to observe activities taking place behind, beside their vehicle. Broaden the scope of the driver's vision, so we want that. Now, gentle people, we're going to talk about a matter, you see, that's very serious. Distraction. In a nutshell, driving under the influence of cell phone is a no-no. Driving under the influence of text messaging is a no-no. These things are recipes for disaster. And there are many studies that have been done. You can do your own research too, you know. We did the research and we found out that NHTSA did this study. Right? 80% of all crashes and 65% of near crashes involve drivers looking away from the forward roadway prior to the incident. Right? So these are some of the things that took place. They were dialing a cell phone, conversing with passengers, tuning the vehicle, tuning the radio or CD player. They check in blind spot, check in speedometer, right? So rear view mirrors, moderate to extreme drowsiness, non-driving related eye glance away from the way, the forward roadway. We have to be game changers, people. We have to be game changers. Now, I tell you already that texting and driving an influence of text, of cell phone and text messaging is a no-no. And let me tell you something. You say headset and hands-free, it's not safer than handle here. Because it's not the hand causing the problem, it's the brain. We see with our brain, people. We see with our brain, not our eyes, we see with our brain. And it's the communication with the brain, our central nervous system, and our subconscious that is causing the problems. Yes, man. So there is no difference, but you will find that globally, the legislation would allow for hands-free. For the most part, governments don't have a choice because the vehicle manufacturers have built the vehicles with Bluetooth technology. It's a figment of your imagination if you think that you can drive under the influence of cell phone and text messaging. Right? It don't make no sense. Yeah, man. Now, people, I want you to pay attention to this presentation, you know, because we want you to do better. So many studies have been done across the US. And we know that this is a risk factor. We know. Right? So we must avoid it. Just avoid it. Right? When you can drive on a road and know that this driver is on a cell phone. You can know just by looking at how they're behaving on the network. You can know. So all the studies have shown that there is no difference between hand-free and handheld. It's all about the communication. This Carnegie Mellon University study, driving while using a cell phone reduces the amount of brain activity associated with driving by 37%. So there are many components of our brain. There's the frontal lobe. There are many sections of the brain. And we're going to talk about the brain. I know it light up. Right? So we reduced the amount of brain activity that's what they're driving by 37%. Recipe for disaster, people. Well, you know, for the most part, people don't readily admit that they were driving under the influence of cell phones because they don't want the police charge them for careless and dangerous driving. So is it cell phone alone cause distraction? No, no. So why are you taking certain people who on phone talking and those things? Because the person on the phone who is talking to you, they don't see that you're running underneath a truck. Mm-hmm. The passenger beside you know when to shut up their mouth. So conversing with passengers is distracting. Eating and drinking is distracting. Reading newspaper, putting on makeup, putting on eyelash, putting on eyeshadow, grooming, brushing teeth while driving, watching video. Let me talk about this. Some of you, you see, those of you who have the steering wheel and have a DVD inside of the steering wheel, take it out. Those of you out there, yes, I see you out there with it. Those of you out there who have that DVD player inside the middle of the steering where the earbud normally is, yes, yes, you know yourself. I tell you, I already take it out. And talk about your whilst driving, you have to watch a movie. Reckless. No. So distracting sources can produce three important behavioral consequences. Diversion of the visual focus away from a critical error. Removal of hand from the steering wheel. Diversion of mental attention away from critical event. People. They have posited that driving under the influence of cell phone, you know, is worse than alcohol level of 0.8, you know. So in other words, what they're telling you is that driving under the influence of cell phone is worse than a drunkard. That's what the study basically said. So what do we encourage? Focus on the driving. Everything else is secondary. Remember, the main goal of defensive driving is to arrive safely to your destination. Remember, you know, that the place that you're going to, it's not moving. And remember that in the books, it say we must live to 3 score and 10 and can get extra. Cell phones and other devices signal reduce your chance of having a safe journey. Never, never, never text and drive. Sometimes you can turn off the phones, you know. Yeah, man. What is more important, the cell phone or your life? You can buy back a cell phone, but you can't get back your life. Mm-hmm. In a few seconds that your eyes and mind are away from the road, your whole world could change dramatically. And you could change the world of other people too. Take a look at these pictures. And thus check yourself if you are guilty of any of these things. If you are guilty, thus make a U-turn, no? Make a U-turn. You do it already. You can't take it back. Would you mind, you feel comfort telling this child's mom you only look down for a second? So this little device, we can't make this little device ruling us. Mankind fly plane, mankind create massive amount of feed, and a little cell phone defeat him. Look at this video. Watch this and us. I'm putting in the chat room what you get from it. Yes,
well,
I wish that you would just bring me, cause your presence in me is here, and it won't leave me alone. These wounds won't seem to heal. This pain is just too
So people, we have to do better. We have to do better. We must do better. We must. We don't have a choice. We don't have a choice. We can't afford to let cell phone let us leave this earth before our time. Look at these pictures. Look at them. Look at them. Look at them. Look at them. Yes.
Hi, you.
Hi, how'd it go?
Yeah, it went well. I'm on my way back now, so I'll tell you about it when I get home.
Okay. Well, the kids are in bed and dinner's on. James? James? Can you hear me?
You don't have to be in a car to cause a crash. Think.
James.
The moment you know they're driving, kill the conversation.
That is true. That is very true. Now, people, those of you who don't love to wear a seatbelt, you are opening up yourself to parachute to the vehicle. Remember that crash in St. James, you see? Just remember that the persons were thrown from that vehicle. Where 3 persons died in St. James, just remember that persons were thrown from the vehicle and nobody in the vehicle was wearing a seatbelt. Just remember that. I want you to remember that. Because sometimes you may think that we are making up stories, right? If you don't wear your seatbelt, you see, you are open. Just know from night till turn to day. We just want to warn you. We just tell you what will happen. We just tell you what will happen. You're going to open up to face and head injuries, and your head is open to being hit at these pillars, this A pillar. And if your head hit this A pillar, that means you could be opened up to traumatic brain injuries. There you could be exposed to cervical spinal injuries, yes. Steering wheel impact, pelvic fracture, and brace leg fracture. Put in the chat room, you see, if you have a spear for all of these. Come on, put in the chat room.
What you're about to see will change your mind about speeding. Two identical cars, one travelling at 60, the other at 65. A sudden change in the road ahead, and both drivers first react, and then, a moment later, they brake. And things start to get interesting. Down here, the difference is extraordinary. In the last 5 metres of braking, you wipe off half your speed. So this car is still doing 32 Ks when it hits. This one also hits, but only at 5 Ks. So no matter how good a driver you are, 5 Ks difference up there makes 27 Ks difference down here.
Gentle people, I hope you are convinced. I hope you are convinced. There are many factors that contribute to traffic crashes. We just want to show you a few of them. We want you to become aware of them. We want you to imbibe them. We want you to know them. Right? And there are many factors that have contributed to the death of persons, the injuries of persons, and to the traffic crashes. Look at it, people. Look at it. Be a game changer. Be a road safety warrior. Do not play with your life. You only have one life, people. Only one life you have. Many have died before their time because they don't hear. And remember, as Granny say, who cannot hear, go and feel. Granny always right, you know. Granny never wrong. Granny always right. Right? People, I want everybody to understand that these pillars on the vehicle, A pillar, right here, A pillar, B pillar, C pillar, right? These are rigid structures of the vehicle. And for the SUVs, the D pillar is right here,
right? Know the pillars of the vehicle, right? Know your vehicle. Get used to it. Your driving instructor should have taught you these things, you know? Yeah, man, your driving instructor should have taught you these things, right? So therefore, now, we want to ensure, this should be a refresher to you. But I know many of you are going to tell me that they never teach you these things. But anyway, we were happy today that we got a phone call from somebody who is interested in learning to be in getting training to be a driving instructor to refer them to Heart Trust NTA. If you want to learn, if you want to be taught how to become a driving instructor to get the ingredients, go to Heart Trust NTA. Right? They thought it was us. No, it's not us. Right? We just provide the information because we have the road safety food. So we are giving you the road safety food. And we want you to eat the road safety food. Yeah, imbibe it. And so when you drive on the road, you remember the road safety message and do the right thing. Now, how do you identify your motor vehicle? Some people complain about not knowing the year of the model. How you know the year of your vehicle? Just check the 10 character of your chassis number. Yeah, just check the 10 character and you will know the model number, right? You'll know the model year. Right, people? So that is all you know, the model year of the vehicle. So it's easy. So once you pick up the model year, then you look at this chart. There's a chart that follows. Yeah, man, you look at that chart. So that chart was M. So that vehicle would have been a 1991 vehicle. Everybody understand that? Let me go again. So those of you who want to know the year, the model year of your vehicle, and you don't want anybody to trick you, right? Nobody do have to trick you, you know? So we have it here. We have everything here. Identifying the motor vehicle. Yeah, we have it right here. So anything you want to know, you can know. If you want to know. If road safety is so important to you, and you consider road safety, you love road safety, you will know these things. Yeah, man. And your driving instructor should have taught you these things. Some people say, Mr. Here, why are you so hard on them? Mr. Because, I have seen wrong things being taught. And when wrong things happen, right, it causes problems. Right? And in the book it says, my people, in Hosea chapter 4, verse 6, the book said, my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. That's what the book says. And through I and I don't want the people to be destroyed anymore. I and I is ensuring that I and I do I and I work by ensuring that the people know the truth. So I have told you in this presentation and in previous presentation about this, but just in case you never watched the previous presentations, you're watching this one now. People, your safety is more important than anything else in this world, yeah? Yeah, man, love life, man, love life. Now, the only safety device that comes with a warning notice is the airbag. It come and said, you look in your vehicle, children can be killed or seriously injured by the airbag. The back seat is the safest place for children. Never put a rear facing child seat in the front. Always use seat belts and child restraint. Read the owner's manual about airbags. Gentle people, airbags deploy in milliseconds. Traffic crashes are over between about 90 to 120 milliseconds, not a second. No traffic crash lasts for a second. So, gentle people, be filled with road safety wisdom, yeah? There's a global recall on the deadly Takata airbag inflators. There is a global recall on the deadly Takata airbag inflators. If you don't believe me, go and research it. The vehicles affected are North American, Japanese, European. And what happened is that when the shrapnel from the airbag inflator fly, it busts up people's face, busts up people's teeth, busts up people's nose, cut people's throat, slice off people's tongue, fly through people's nose hole and clap them brain. Hello. Why are so hard of hearing? Doesn't the must go to the dealer and go find out if you're driving around with a deadly Takata airbag inflator. Why? You're going to wait. Are you going to wait until the deadly Takata airbag inflator busts through the airbag and cut off your neck, cut out your tongue, bust your face, bust your throat, fly through your nose hole and clap your brain? Is that your weapon? Well, guess what? You cannot say the road safety will never tell you. Because the last time I checked, you know, I realized that my people not going to check. They're taking it for jokes. One lady said that she think when I speak, it was a joke. I have to ask her if she think that when I talk, I'm making jokes. I'm not making any jokes. I want to know what's going to happen. And I don't want them to you. Because guess what? I know somebody whose earbag inflator, deadly Takata earbag inflator fly and mash them up. And they have to be learning to speak again. I warn you, you know, I warn everybody. Right? But many not taking heed. Those who have ears to hear, let them hear. Who can hear will feel. Oh, we have made numerous clarion calls about this matter. Toyota Jamaica is there. KIG is there. Stewart's is there. ATL is there. And people are begging drivers of the vehicles affected to come. And many of you talk about you cannot spend the 45 minutes. Well, people, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. It takes hours to do a surgery here. Let me just tell you that. Take hours to do a surgery. Hear the word of the road safety man. Go to your dealer and check. It doesn't matter if you bought the vehicle from the dealer. Mechanisms have been put in place from headquarters who control that vehicle with the dealer to have these matters dealt with. But we need you people, because we know that many of you are driving around with the deadly Takata earbag inflator, and it's just a matter of time. Just a matter of time. But all I can say, nobody in this country will ever be able to say the road safety unit never did tell you. Never. You're not going to get that opportunity at all. No, no, no. No, 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 no. We have been telling people this from 2018. The road safety unit on record from as far back as 2000 when we found out this. We found out this thing in 2018 and we have been begging the people. This is what a deadly Takata earbag inflator do. I have photographs of people who it mash up in them, but I'm not going to show you any photograph. So nobody don't ask me for any photograph. I'm not going to show you. I'm not going to send anybody for them. I have photographs of people who the earbag inflator, clap them eyeball, clap it. So this is not makeup story.
I don't want to look away now. This is it. Listen to the echo. The Focus is obliterated on impact. Only the rear end escapes total destruction. And the passengers... don't ask.
God, the hairs on the back of my neck are sharp as nails.
The car decelerates from 120 miles an hour to zero in 68 milliseconds, with its occupants experiencing peaks of 400 G. The front end hits the wall with such force that the back end rises up 90 degrees and the car is slam dunked down onto its nose. Crash test expert Tony Payne talked me through the scale of this wreckage.
Absolutely mauled. Yes, you've got the vehicle crushed nearly all the way back to the B pillar. You can see here, for an occupant in there, absolutely no survival space at all.
Right. There's the rear seat, and there's the steering wheel there, and literally it's been compressed between the front and rear seat down to that distance.
Goodness me. It's almost turned into a piece of modern art.
And if we go right round into the car itself...
Front seat's right in there. That's the instrumentation panel, and the person's literally in that area there.
I mean, I know it's all not real, but it's still mighty haunting.
It is an extreme scenario, but modern family hatchbacks can reach the speeds we saw today. Maybe it'll make you think twice the next time you want to put your foot down.
I really hope so. I think I would like persons to know, we have a lot of persons negotiating corners, and because they're going so fast, the vehicle end up washing, the term we use in Jamaica, and they end up losing control of the vehicle, and then they end up causing serious crashes and even deaths and injuries. A yaw is caused by a rotating tire, which is also side slipping. When a vehicle is negotiating a curve, normally with no wheel side slipping, each rear tire is said to track inside the part of its corresponding front tire. What do I mean by that? Look at this photograph now. You see, when you are driving normally, the rear tire, yes, tracks inside of the front tire, right? Inside. You see, when this rear tire starts to track outside the front tire, the vehicle is yawing, the vehicle is washing, and this can cause it to end up in boneyard. I hope everybody understands that. Let me go again. So normal driving, right? The rear tire track inside of the front tire, right? Again, it's not my fault. The instructor never teach you these things, right? So don't ask me how you must know that. The instructor is supposed to have taught that. If the instructor did work himself, he would have taught you this. Gentle people, try not to get into a yaw. Now, what they have done, they put in, you will notice that some vehicles have electronic stability control now. So what they did, they placed electronic stability control in the vehicle, which is a computerized system, to monitor the tires to ensure, to prevent the tires from yawing, right? So that's a safe, added safety feature in the motor vehicle. I'm going to speak about some more safety features that exists in motor vehicles. So the yaw, this is because the vehicle's sidestep angle increase as the yaw continues. Yaw marks have diagonal striations which run obliquely to the length of the mark. These marks are caused by unusual pressure on the tire as it slides sideways. So the tire is sliding sideways. Yeah, man, sideways. Mm-hmm. Right? So this is what the marks look like. They would tend to look like fishbone marks. There's going to be some crossover at some point that they look like fishbones, yeah? We have to talk about that issue because I see too much emergency vehicles operating on the network and people think it is cute for them to be hitchhiking behind them. It is illegal. So what is an emergency vehicle? An emergency vehicle must have siren on, right? And it must have on something on the top with flashing light. That's an emergency vehicle. What are those vehicles? They're ambulance, police vehicle, fire brigade. Those are emergency vehicles, right? And they are normally marked and designated accordingly, right? So once you hear the siren on and the flasher, you need to give them prior right of passage, right? So they must have a siren on, and they must have, the flasher is built on the vehicle. So that is what makes it an emergency vehicle, right? It must have those things. That's what the law said, right? So you should stop and give them way. You should not follow closer than 500 feet behind an emergency vehicle. I continue to see people itching up under emergency vehicles. It's illegal.
She's got quite legs. She's got really good legs. How old is she?
She'd be like 60, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't wear skirts like that now. Yeah. I reckon she's incredible.
Yeah, absolutely.
She was a dancer. I reckon she looks sensational.
What are you playing with your spot again,
eh?
Don is about to kill his wife. He can't blame a freak accident. He can't blame the truck. All he can blame is his speed. For every 5Ks over the limit, your risk of crashing falls. It's never safe to speed.
Gentle people, this is our weekend. Don't speed. If you are tired, get rest, people. Get rest. If you are tired, get rest. Right? Things that accompany tiredness, low energy level, lowered physical exertion, increased physical discomfort, decreasing motivation, and sleepiness. Once you feel tired, get rest. Get rest. Stop depriving yourself of sleep. Stop driving these long distance hours and tired. You may not reach your destination. You may die before your time, right? People, you have family members who love you, right? You have family members who want to see you home. Many persons have not made it home because they fell asleep at the wheel, right? We have seen many occasions where we are left with no other conclusion but to say that this person was asleep. Right? We have seen many deaths fitting this criteria. We have seen many deaths. Please, people, I cannot request it anymore. If you're tired, get rest. Stop depriving yourself of sleep. It affects your ability to react to eventuality in traffic environment, right? So if nothing is important to you, right? Think about your children. Think about your family members. I am certain that that's supposed to move you to want to live for your mother, your father, your brother, your sister,
your uncle him, and your children and your queen. Yes. Are your king man. Right. So try not to stress out yourself over anything. Life is like a wave, it oscillates. There are peaks and there are troughs. There are ups and there are downs. That's how life is. That's how life was built by Elohim. We are conquerors. Alexander the Great, when his generals saw him, three generals saw him crying, they asked him, why are you crying? He said, there are no more worlds to be conquered. Let us conquer road safety and be road safety game changers, and let us do the right thing out there. Let us ensure that we don't say we're drinking stimulants in order to stay up because we want to drive long hours. It's a figment of our imaginations. Rest mean rest. Get rest. No energy drink, no tobacco, no coffee, no tea, no chocolate is going to help you. Rest mean rest. The body says sleep time, sleep time. As a matter of fact, your body was designed to sleep at night. There are certain minerals that come in your body when you drop asleep at night. Right? People who love take amphetamines, we need to stop it. Right? We need to stop it. There is no substitute for sleep. Sleep means sleep. Right? If you're tired, find a safe place and take a nap. Find a safe place. Don't stop anywhere. Oh, don't stop any and anywhere. Find a safe. If you can find a police station, stop at a police station and take a nap. Yes, take a nap there. Police station normally safe. Right? So, gentle people, people have countermeasures that they use. Eat snacks, chew gum, listen to CD player radio, driving barefoot or talking to oneself. All these things have not been found to be effective. Only thing that based on my intelligence and the research, the only antidote for fatigue is sleep. You know, when operating in a traffic environment, we must be able to detect, appraise situation and make decision and react. So there's something known as perception reaction time that relates to how we detect things, how we make an assessment, appraisal, how we make decisions, and how we react or respond. It does not include the time taken for the vehicle to respond. Based on the many studies that have been executed, I found that mankind react between 1.5 to 2 seconds to a roadway hazard. Right? But that is if the person is sober, alert, and attentive, and this study was done in daylight condition. So I'm almost certain that that if we were to look at night, it would be worse than 1.5 to 2 seconds. We don't find anybody who is willing to do these studies at night because you know you may not come out alive. And I'm not going to do it either. Now, perception reaction time can be affected by individual differences from one driver to the next, the level of expectancy for the hazard, the degree of driver's alertness and attentiveness, or the conspicuity of the hazard. And that is why we need to have reflectors on the road network, and we need to have reflectors on our vehicle so that other drivers can see us. Because if we don't, they can't see us, we are going to be in trouble. Now, perception reaction time can be affected by all of these things. And really and truly, people, play a positive role in these things, right? We need to be cognizant of these things. And honestly, you should have been taught these things, right? We are going to come with some more things next week, yes? And we hope that you will be a game changer. So drive sober, right? These things affect reaction time. Alcohol and drugs increase your reaction time. Try and focus only on driving. And also, if you have not received defensive driving training, go and get it. Go and get it. Go and get it. Be patient out there. Allow enough time and distance to react to other road users in the traffic environment. Anticipate that other road users will behave in an unpredictable manner and be prepared to react. Many hazards first appear in the fuzzy peripheral region, so attend to these areas. Say following distance, you have heard about the 2 and 3 second rule, right? Say following distance is where we give enough time and distance to perceive, react, and avoid a collision by steering or braking if the hazard appears suddenly in front of us. Safe following distance is always measured in time, so we need to be cognizant of that. And I said before, the 2 to 3 second rule. Easy, people, easy. Your instructor is supposed to teach you this. I think it's because we haven't really taught our people properly to drive on the road network, why we see people tailgate so much. So how do you deal with the 2 to 3 second rule? How you do it? You find a landmark, right? You find a landmark, right? So maybe the landmark is this tree. So one moment this vehicle come at this tree, I begin to count 1001, 1002, 1003. And say I reach right here, I would have reached in before, right? So that means I'm traveling at a safe distance. But say, for example, I'm here and I'm counting here when the vehicle here, and I say 1001, 1002, 1003. No, man, I'm going too fast. So I need to cut the speed, right? I need to cut the speed. So that is how simple it is. Look at the vehicle ahead and observe where the rear part passes a landmark. Count out 3 seconds, 1001, 1002, 1003. All right? And if you reach the landmark before, you know that you are going too fast. After, if you pass the landmark before the 3 seconds, that means you are too close, right? If you don't reach there within the 3 seconds, you're all right. Another thing you can use to mark if you are too close to a vehicle, can you see the rear tire of the vehicle in front of you? If you can't, people, you are too close, right? So you make that. If you're operating commercial vehicles, you are expected to adjust this the time to up to 6 to 7 seconds. Why? Because of the trucks are built differently, because they have air brake systems. It has been recommended that if your vehicle, if you have the weather condition, large vehicle, towing large, etc., hilly or winding road, driving at night and wet or slippery road, adjust this by 1 second and increase the following distance. If you don't feel good, you feel ill or tired, adjust it accordingly. Keep your distance, people. Keep your distance. Tailgating is the reason for most traffic crashes in Jamaica. It's the act of following under the heels of another vehicle. And we are supposed to drive in such a way that we can stop. Stopping distance is the product of thinking distance and braking distance. And a lot of it is intertwined to the speed at which you are traveling at. So for example, if you're traveling at 32 kilometers per hour, you're still going to take 12 kilometers to stop. But you have to think about it, then stop. And for 50 kilometers per hour, 23 meters, and the speed go up, depending on the speed. Now, these things can be tested. These things have been tested, and these things are for real. Don't play with it, it's for real. We have done some tests on these things already, and we found out it's for real. It's for real, right? So don't take it for granted, right? Thinking decides associated reaction time. Drivers react between 1 to 1.5 seconds, some drivers, right? So be mindful of that. Factors that affect thinking distance, driver's health, alcohol, drugs, medication, fatigue, and the psychological factor. Drivers so affected can have their reaction increase profoundly. Things that affect braking distance is coefficient of friction
or drag factor between the tire and the road surface, weather condition, condition of tires, type of road surface, gradient of the road surface. These are things that we have to take into consideration. So you look at this chart, it tells you the stopping distance. Get used to it. Your instructor should have taught you these things. If the instructor have not, send it to your instructor so you begin to teach the new people that you're dealing with. This is very important information, people. And I really hope and pray that you would have learned something from this presentation and that you would have made a decision to be a road safety game changer, to be a road safety warrior. I want to thank you very much for watching us. Thank you very much for taking the time out to listen to what we have to say. Share it with your friends, share it with your family, share it with everybody. Right? Thank you. Thank you. God bless you this weekend. Have a safe weekend. And we look forward to seeing you next weekend. Thank you. Right? Thank you. Thank you. God is good all the time.